The escalating political turmoil here in the Philippines. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. firing back after Vice President Sara Duterte publicly threatened to have him killed. Security agencies also working round the clock as they try to uncover Duterte's alleged assassination plot. Katrina Domingo reports.
So how is that?
Days after Vice President Sara Duterte divulged that she has plotted to kill President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and some of his family members should a death threat against her prosper, the president made it clear that he would not take these threats lightly and described his second-in-command's statements as criminal and alarming.
Kung ganun na lang kadali ang pagplano sa pagpatay ng isang presidente, paano pa kaya ang mga pangkaraniwan na mamamayan? Yang ganyang kriminal na pagtatangka ay hindi dapat pinapalampas. Yan ay aking papalagan.
The chief executive underscored that the situation would not have escalated into threats if only the vice president participated in congressional investigations and directly answered questions on how she spent her confidential funds.
Ang katotohanan ay hindi dapat itokhang. Tapos na sana ang usapang ito kung tutuparin lamang ang sinumpaang panata na bilang lingkod bayan ay magsabi ng totoo at hindi hahadlangan. Imbis na diretsahang sagot, nililihis pa sa kwentong chicheria.
Shortly after the president's announcement, the Justice Department confirmed that it has begun looking for Duterte's possible hired assassins and described the Philippines' second highest official as a self-confessed mastermind of an assassination plot against the president.
The premeditated plot to assassinate the president, as declared by the self-confessed mastermind, will now face legal consequences. We are tapping our law enforcement agents to investigate on the whereabouts and the identity of this person and persons who may be plotting against the president. We will use all the resources of government, all law enforcement agents, to find out the identity of this assassin and the legal consequences arising out of this criminal plot will be dealt with the full force of the law.
While Duterte claims that her statement over the weekend was maliciously taken out of logical context, the Justice Department says they cannot simply disregard these statements, as this is not the first time that Duterte expressed intentions to harm the chief executive. In a press conference in October, Duterte told reporters that she wanted to behead Marcos Jr. after the president declined to give his watch to a student who asked for it as a graduation gift.
Na gusto niyang pugutan ng ulo ang ating pangulo. Tinanggap po namin na salita yon in a metaphorical way. Ngunit sa kanya pong bagong pananalita, hindi po maaring isang tabi lang yan. She is the beneficiary of the death of the president. So her words have to be taken in the proper context. That is a very serious action taken by the VP.
DOJ Prosecutor General Richard Anthony Fadulyon says they are studying the possible cases that can be filed against Duterte. Among these are charges of grave threat, sedition, and even disbarment.
She will be given an opportunity to present your side. Ngayon, kung hindi siya tumugon, hindi naman po pwedeng tayo ay maghintay hanggang sila ay good and ready. At sila hindi tumugon, wala tayong magagawa kundi patupad ang batas.
The DOJ underscores that investigations against the vice president will test the quality of the Philippine justice system. Meanwhile, the Presidential Security Command heightened security protocols in Malacañang. The PSC has yet to discuss if they will require the president to wear bulletproof vests or if he should deliver public speeches behind bulletproof podiums. While Duterte asserts that she has also received death threats, the NBI said that they have yet to receive such intelligence information. When asked if the vice president should be suspended for triggering these political feuds and investigations, the DOJ says that it is a matter left to the ombudsman's discretion. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.
House Speaker Martin Romualdo is also breaking his silence on the alleged death threat made by Vice President Sara Duterte. Speaking during Monday's House plenary session, Romualdo condemned Duterte's remarks, describing them as alarming and unprecedented.
Hindi na to biro. Hindi na to normal na panalita. Isa itong direktang banta sa ating demokrasya, sa ating pamahalaan, at sa seguridad ng bayan. Such statement is not just reckless, it is dangerous. It sends a chilling message to our people. A message that violence can be contemplated by those in positions of power. This is not just an affront to the individuals targeted, it is attack on the very foundation of our government. It is an insult to every Filipino who believes in the rule of law and the sanctity of life.
He also dismissed Duterte's accusations he is plotting to destroy her due to supposed political ambitions. Romualdo called the claims a desperate attempt to divert public attention from pressing issues.
Why these baseless accusations? The answer is simple. To divert attention from the mounting evidence of fund misuse under her leadership at the Office of the Vice President and Department of Education. The issues surrounding confidential and intelligence funds, the questionable disbursements, and the lack of transparency demand answers.
Now, the Philippine military chief calls on soldiers to remain loyal to the Constitution amid the vice president's worsening feud with President Marcos Jr. General Romeo Browner reminded troops to stay competent and professional. Browner urged them to focus on their mandate to serve the country, the armed forces, and their commander-in-chief.
In the past days, we have seen a myriad of events that transpired in our country. And this has shaken the political environment of our country. As soldiers, we should not be shaken by this. Sinabi po natin that we vow to defend the Constitution of the Philippines. No? That means that we have to follow the chain of command.
Special disbursing officers from the Education Department and the Office of the Vice President revealed to lawmakers they were not responsible for disbursing their agency's confidential funds. Former DepEd SDO Edward Fajarda disclosed that a certain Dennis Nolasco, appointed by Vice Presidential Security and Protection Group Commander Colonel Raymond La Chica, handled the disbursement of secret funds. Earlier hearings revealed Fajardo withdrew over 112 million pesos in confidential funds through three checks last year.
Your Honor, si Colonel Nolasco po kasi ang expert sa confidential operation.
Sino po ang nagbigay ng pahintulot o ng kapangyarihan para si Colonel Nolasco po ang mag-disburse ng pera?
Your Honor, si BP Sara po.
Similarly, the OVP disbursement officer Gina Acosta said she withdrew 125 million pesos in confidential funds, also disbursed by Colonel La Chica.
Because po my utos po si Ma'am Inday Sara na sa kanya ko po i-release kasi siya po ang nakakaalam kung paano po i-implement ang mga programs and programs and activities in line po sa confidential fund. Okay. Siya po ang mag-survey, surveillance and monitoring po. Sa kanya po yun, wala po akong alam.
After her testimony, Acosta was rushed to the Veterans Memorial Medical Center, citing dizziness and feeling shaky. The Vice President's Chief of Staff, Zulaika Lopez, has also been confined there. She fell ill after the House ordered her transfer to the Women's Correctional in Mandaluyong.